Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I want to discuss with you renting accommodation in Germany. Finding a rented house in your own country is difficult, and in a different country is more difficult, especially when the language is so different, system is so different. That is why I thought I will make a vlog on this, a comprehensive vlog in which you will find all the information you will ever need. So first, where you will have to look for the accommodation. There are certain websites, like first is eBay Kleinanzeigen, and Kleinanzeigen means small advertisements. Then there is a website called Immobilien Scout24.de. I will write everything on the screen. And Immowelt.de. These are the most common websites. Otherwise, here in the supermarket, there is also some notice always hung that tenant wanted. Naturally in German, Mieter gesucht. Otherwise, if you are looking for an accommodation from outside Germany, you will go on these websites and wohnunggesucht.de. Or if there is, you have a university, you are coming here as a student, then your university counselor will also help in finding accommodation. They can also give you suitable links. But otherwise, these are the most common websites. Otherwise, if you come here in Germany and you still don't have the apartment, then you can always go to a property dealer. They will charge commission of 1 month or 2 month of the rent, and then they will look for the property according to your needs. First, on the website also, you will first give the location where you are looking for the location. I will say look for the location where it is your university is, where you will be studying, or where there your job is located. So look on that city. If you don't want in the city itself, sometimes it is very expensive. Like in Munich, Frankfurt, it is very expensive to find a accommodation. So people generally find a suburb near to that city, It is very, you can look for the like 40 kilometers radius, 50 kilometers radius, the distance which are comfortable in traveling. Most of the Germany is very well connected with the trains and buses, etc. So it will be easier for you to commute. Otherwise, you can also buy a second-hand car and then you can commute. Otherwise, most of the time, the public transport is really very good. You will not find a problem to, reach your destination, especially like universities and main famous offices. They are always well connected with different parts of the Germany. Then comes the option that do you want, how many rooms you want. So you are looking for a two-room apartment. In Germany, doesn't go like that. Like you are looking for two-room means one will be the two-bedroom apartment and one living room will be the extra. So always in the specifications, it will be like two-bedroom plus there will be kitchen, plus there will be a bathroom, and plus there will be a living room. Living room will be always extra. If there is saying two-room apartment, it is actually two-bedroom apartment. And also the size of the apartment really depends upon the size of the family. For example, we are four members in the family, so we are living, our minimum condition is that they have to we have to rent according to the 70 square meter. Below that, it cannot go. Property dealer will not give the apartment, because according to the law, at least per person, per member of the family, you have to have 17-18 meters square. So you, according to do, you can do the math, that you can't say that okay, I will just to save money. People have their own preferences, like if you to save money, they will go for one room apartment and all four members of the family will live in that. It doesn't go like that. It really depends on the size of the family. And also there are different types of apartments available. Some will be furnished, some will be unfurnished. Most of the time it is unfurnished. Unfurnished means there will not be sometimes even a kitchen. Means kitchen also you have to build yourself, buy from the supermarket and do it. Even the bulbs in the apartment will not be there. You will have to hang the bulbs, do the lighting yourself. Yeah, there will be the bathtub according to the if there is bathtub or a shower area, it will be built in. There will be sink there. There will be toilet that will be built. That area will be built. But otherwise, like kitchen, lighting, sofa set, everything, almirahs, you will have to buy. Sometimes some things are available, but really depends on from the apartment to apartment. Most of the time, it is completely empty. Only bathroom and toilets are, the things are there. Otherwise, whole apartment is totally empty and you will have to do yourself. And then according to the rent is like that. But if you're going for furnished apartment, like you're new here and you don't want to go through the hassle, then you can also go for a furnished apartment, the rent will be a little bit higher, but it will be more convenient. Otherwise, there are many second-hand shops also for the furniture, and there is IKEA here. There are so many other furniture markets here, Roller, Pralin, Poco, really so many, XXL, there are really so many. So you will not have any problem as such, but still it depends. So I'm just giving you an option. If you are looking for the advertisement section, you will sometimes come across our terms like EBK. EBK is Einbau Küche. Einbau Küche means kitchen is already installed. And if they say there is no EBK, it means it is not installed. You will also have to see if the lift is there or not, because sometimes there are 4-5 floors and there is no lift. And sometimes there is lift, then that is extra charged. Those costs are also charged, which is my next point, that rent here is of two parts. One is cold rent, one is warm rent. Cold rent is simply your basic rent, and warm rent is that on that basic rent you will have to pay certain other cost of the apartment, like your water cost, your gas cost, and your the lift maintenance cost, your cost to maintain your stairwell, like somebody will come to clean the stairwell, that area, stairs, lobby to clean, or the lighting in that staircase, maintenance of the building insurance. All those costs are covered in those that is an estimated amount, that okay, your 600 is your cold rents, for example. They are charging you 200 euro plus apartment cost, and it will come around 800 euro will be the rent you will be paying. That 200 euro which I'm saying is totally estimated. Suppose at the end of the year the bill comes and you have paid too much already, and in advance, then they will refund you that amount. Suppose you actually used only 100 euro per month of the cost or of the electricity or the gas, then they will you will have to pay less. But if you incurred more cost and you have paid less, then you will have to pay more at the end of the year. These apartment costs are actually more commonly known as the Nebenkosten in German. And just to let you know, because in advertisement that is how it will be written. And there will be also be security deposit, which is called Kaution here. And that Kaution is for 2-3 months of the cold rent, like either 2 months or 3 months, depends upon from the property dealer or your landlord of the house, that they will ask for 2 months of cold rent or 3 months of the cold rent. And then that you have to pay only if you first you have to sign the rent contract. First sign the rent contract, only then transfer the amount. Because sometimes I already told you the website's name, but sometimes there are also ads on Facebook and eBay also. And these are fake, they are fraudsters. I also mentioned about this in my vlog about scams in Germany. If you haven't watched it, you can watch it. And I will put the link in the description. And if you I told you that you went through those ads, and those ads are fake, it is, and you transfer the money without signing the contract, you are duped, you're conned. So always first sign the contract and then transfer the money, and get the apartment key also in hand. I will actually say that first transfer the money only after getting the key of the apartment. First look at the apartment. And whenever you shift into the apartment, first take the photos of the apartment, because sometimes there is some problem, if something is broken down, or some paint is off, and there is some property destroyed already, then you can already say that look, these damages were before we moved in. So later on landlord will not charge you for those damages. So if you're not in Germany, then it is a bit difficult. But if you're already in Germany, please have a proper look at the apartment before signing the contract also, because sometimes the photos are something else and in reality apartment is look something else. And that is how you security deposit works, that first you sign the contract, you transfer the money, the person will give you the keys, and then you move in. But be very careful about the process, that you have met the person and you are sure that that person is genuine, and it is not too good to be true, that rent is too low and you just transfer the money and then it is fake. Then the rent contract. Rent contract you have to study very carefully that car garage is allowed or not, you have a storeroom or not, pets are allowed or not, and really read the those rules and regulations, because every apartment will have their own rules. Washing clothes. Most of the apartments, they have in the basement washing machines where you are allowed to wash the clothes, and washing machine is not allowed in the apartment because of the thin walls, and it will, you know, disturb the other tenants, other people living in the building. So you will have to go to the basement to wash the clothes. Some apartments do have the facility of washing machine in the apartment also. And the same way that internet connection will be like, the port will be there, yes, you can get that, but internet connection, it is higher chances that you will have to apply for internet connection yourself. All the apartments, when we will go for the even the inspection of the apartment, the landlord will always require some documents from you, like your ID, your you know, residence permit of the this, your passport, and your salary slips to show that you are able to pay the rent. Around 3 salary slips they really normally want. These is documents, it will be better if when you go to look for the house, if you're in Germany or you go to look for the house, this documents should be in your hand so that you can show to the property dealer immediately. Or you can also show mail them later on, but most of the time competition is so hard, it is really very difficult to find a rented accommodation, especially in, you know, main cities like Frankfurt, Munich, or even in Aachen where there are so many students. So it is very difficult. So always be a little bit, you know, it is like applying for a job. You will have to really show to the agent, the property dealer, or to the landlord that yes, you are a good candidate for this, having this apartment. When you're looking at the apartment for all these websites, you're you know, and you want to apply for this looking, you want to look at the apartment, or you want to send a message to the landlord or property dealer, then I will prefer that first you write a message in German, like you can Google Translate whatever you want to write in English. First Google Translate into German, because there are so many people who don't know English here, or their English is not as good, they will prefer it to read the message in German, and later on down under the message write in English also, so that if there is some ambiguity in your Google Translate is also not 100% correct, right? So you have written everything in English as well. Landlord will really like it if you will do like that, and read the advertisement very careful, that what type of tenant they are looking for. It is a Wohngemeinschaft. Wohngemeinschaft means when 3-4 students are living together, or it is a single family house. So you have to really read through the advertisement. According to that, you have to apply. So I hope my these tips will help you in finding the apartment very easily, and I will write some abbreviations in the description box also, which will help you in looking for the accommodation and understanding what these in German these things mean. I hope you find my information useful, and if you did, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends so that they can also get help, and tell me in the comment box your opinion, your suggestions, how I can make my vlogs better, and if you want me to cover some type of topic, I will be happy to help you in any way I can. I will see in my next vlog. Till then, take very good care of yourself. Stay healthy, stay happy, and stay blessed. Bye bye.